guys, welcome back to Call of Cthulhu. We are still in dark water. We are still sneaking around, and we have to make a decision on whether we are going to heal Kat or Mitchell. And I think what I have decided to do is heal Kat. Mitchell, we've only seen in the very beginning. Kat, we've had more of a connection with. Even though she tried to cut her face off at one point and has been mean and nasty to us.
Shit. They're going to the whaling station. I'd better hide and wait until they're gone.
I can get to her without having to kill too many people. That's who I want to heal. She's who I would like to try and save. So. There's like three guys in the room. Or more. Can we make it between them? How are we going to get up the stairs without killing this guy? Because as soon as I walk by him, he's going to grab me. Thank you. get up, 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 get up. Run! That was very sloppy.
Get me a first aid kit. I might have something for you.
Here, take it.
Right. The entrance to the whaling station is behind the Hawkins warehouse.
To go through earlier. Are they out there? Okay. I think that was the warehouse we tried to go through. Maybe.
Your path.
scary detective. Come on, we're done. Yep, good. Go that way. The other gated area back in behind that we saw. I'm extremely dumb today. So we need to sneak by him. Come on, just keep on moving. Seriously, need to just go away. Oh, really? Go away. Go, please go. I close that. Thank you. Alright. Oh, that could have gone better.
My skin.
I don't want your skin, honest. I have my own. Oh, jeez Louise. Alright. Well, at least we know where we need to go. Problems. Just gonna sneak right on by you. I saw that guy go up there, so I'm gonna go up this way. You asked for it. I warned you. And here we go again. And let's see what we have. That way, and we know there's a little zombie dude over there. Yeah, it looks like it. Oh, I wonder how wide his path is. Dude, go away, because I will shoot you. Yeah. Okay, he also enters quickly. You just keep going that way. Oh, what's up in here? Is this just a hidey hole? Oh, jeez! Sorry about that. What are you doing? Do I have to kill you? Dang it. Seriously. Go away. I'm trying to look for clues and... Thank you. man. Well, that could have gone a lot better, but we made it. And let's see what Sarah's doing and what kind of grief she's causing everybody here. It probably would have been a lot easier to sneak by them if I'd gone a little slower, I guess. I wouldn't have had to kill so many of them.
Hither thou shalt be free. Sarah is with those bastards. I gotta find her quick.
Get into the main room. Well, I really don't think Sarah is on our side. I see it. Let me just check over here real quick. See what this was.
This tank seems strong enough to break down the door.
Oh. This is the warehouse from our dream earlier in the game. I think when the tunnel collapsed on us. And right before we woke up in the asylum for the first time, I think that's our dream from there. I don't know if I actually need to sneak around here or what, but we're going to.
A rope and a hook. Could use that to hold the reservoir back.
Relatively thick rope to which a metal hook is attached. It must be used to pick up heavy material. It looks strong enough to take the weight of the tank. Okay, I see where I need to go. But let us explore around, make sure we're not missing any thing. We need any more rope? No? It might be safe enough to stand up and look, but I am not taking any chances. What's out there? Ooh, there's a clue in here. Oh, there it is.
Looks like a page from a log from 1847.
We are starving. The fish seems to have deserted these waters. If I don't quickly find an answer to this crisis, Fitzroy could well set off a mutiny. Each day, more and more men believe in his tale of a miraculous catch. Merciful God, help me. We sighted an enormous whale further to the south. The biggest we've ever seen. Fitzroy keeps telling the men that this is the miraculous catch he promised them. We will catch it and bring it back home to feed our families. Log one. That means there might be more than one. Oh, what was that?
Another volume of the Reverend's wife's diary.
Volume 5. These are the last entries of the pastor's wife. Her husband ordered his faithful to come together for a final ceremony in the honor of Leviathan. She fears that the pastor will ask them to sacrifice themselves to this abomination. She tried to escape. This is probably why her body was found in a cave under the mansion. Okay. Well, I'm glad I found all of them. Another door. For the whaling offices. We've got a hidden... back here, maybe? What am I overlooking? There we go.
Fuller was a crew member, too. Interesting.
The morning is biting cold. This creature made us work hard. Half of my crew is dead. I've never seen such a thing. I do not even know how to describe what happened. It's as if the creature was talking inside our heads. Some of my men went crazy and jumped overboard. This thing is not a whale. It's far bigger. I don't even know how to describe it. It practically gutted our ship with these tentacles. I don't know how my harpoon finally pierced the skull of this monster. The crew is in a sorry state. Fuller looks after the injured, but some will not recover. I think I hear Sarah singing again.
Sarah Hawkins was probably taken behind this huge door. Got to find a way to get through.
Yeah, I know. I know what I'm doing. Just want to make sure we've got everything and we don't click on this. Nope. Okay, let's go attach a rope, I guess. Anything here? Yeah, we have to go up higher. Another door.
I'll be lucky if it's still sharp enough. Doesn't work. It mentions the Leviathan, how it drove the sailors mad.
The whole crew has descended into madness. They speak of dreams, visions of a nightmarish city, and of a sleeping god. Madness. I locked myself in my cabin. I won't be able to hold out for long. Fitzroy has 12 men on his side. They sacrificed everyone who tried to stop them to their new god. I beseech you, Almighty God, to have pity on our souls. This will be my last prayer. I can hear them whispering. Page 4. I wonder where page 3 is. Yeah, there we go. That's what we needed. See what I need to do. Just wanna. Oh, we already checked there. Okay. So.
This should stop the cart from moving. This should help me get the tank swinging.
Hmm.
I need something to cut the rope to release the tank against the door.
Ah, we have a knife. All right, are we ready for this? They heard that? Probably, huh? All right, down we go.
Voice. You're the Leviathan. Who is this?
The quest for truth requires sacrifice. There's no room for compassion.
Who's there?
Your stubbornness, wanting to help others who would have deserted you, is a weakness. Fate leads us inevitably to solitude, and in one's final moments, one is always alone. You can't escape it forever. It will always find its way.
Damn it!
What in the world? Where are we? Yeah. I don't know how it won't let me go back any farther. Really? What in the world? Alright, dude, freak out. Don't freak out.
Sailors were going insane. Fitzroy and the mutineers took over the ship and probably killed the captain.
This is log 3. Fitzroy encouraged the men all day. They are in shock and can't overcome their trauma. They say they can hear the screams of their comrades turned mad. Some of them hurt themselves in a desperate attempt to stop the visions that haunted them. Others chose to embrace them. Fitzroy is one of the latter. He named the beast Leviathan because he believes in his biblical nature. I told them to get rid of it before it's too late. This thing is not the work of God.
Everything points back to the day they brought in that thing.
A forgotten photo in the offices of the whaling station. Only a handful of the Scylla crew is present. Captain Fitzroy and Dr. Fuller are included. It is dated 1847. Before we go out, wrong button. Let me check and see how many points we have to assign. We have 9. Okay. Well, yeah, we can go a little bit longer. Let's go see what Sarah has to say for herself as we slowly freak out. Oh, really? Like the lock kick this?
Perfect.
Ooh, what's this? Oh, I cannot see it. Alright, it won't let me do anything with that.
Learn to obey.
Okay, here we go.
Ah, finally awake. How do you feel, Mr. Pierce?
Fuller! Son of a bitch! I'll kill you!
No, I'm not even really with you. Well, to be perfectly precise, I am with you, but not in this cell.
What have you done to me?
Me? Nothing, really. See, it's one of the exquisite effects of this incredible creature.
Leviathan!
I see you already know about it. Well, shall we begin?
I'd really rather not. This doesn't shrink me. No, don't. I said don't take it. Did I not say don't take it? I really could have swore I said don't take it. No, we are not eating a bat. It's not going to let me go on, is it? Oh, come on. I do not want to eat that. No. Ugh. Fine. Nope, don't eat. I said don't eat. Really? Why give me a choice if you're not going to give me a choice?
Let me take a sample from you. Flesh, blood, spinal fluids. Don't fear. I created the mythological ichor from Leviathan's flesh. Who knows what I can make with you? I need your body for my research.
It's old and tough. You don't need my body for anything. What choice do I not get to make this time? Seriously? Don't take the gun.
I killed him.
No, you didn't.
A necessary sacrifice that proves your determination.
for a game. Alright, is it really you this time? Nope. Didn't think so.
Find the truth and be free.
Seven, eight, nine doors to choose from. I believe we shall try the doors in the next episode. Thank you for joining me. I'm Ball Girl, and I hope to see you in the next one.